Hi, my name is Jim Cheshire, and I'm a Senior Escalation Engineer on the Windows Azure Websites team at Microsoft. This is the first of four videos on diagnostics in Windows Azure Websites. In this first video, we're going to look at how you can use detailed error messages to find the details of errors that might be occurring in your Windows Azure Websites. So let's get started. I've just published an ASP.NET MVC application to Windows Azure Websites. But for some reason, when I browse to the site, all I see is this error message. Now, I don't really know from this message what the problem is, but it's pretty clear that something bad has happened. In a situation like this, I can use detailed error messages to find out what's wrong. So let's have a look at how to do that. I'll pull up the Azure portal, and I'll go ahead and go into the settings for this website. Now I need to pull up the configure page here in the portal so that I can turn on some diagnostics. And I'll scroll down to the site diagnostics section here. And in the site diagnostics section, I can see a setting here for detailed error messages. Let's change this setting to on, and then I'll click save. Now it's important to remember that detailed error messages don't actually show up in the browser when an error occurs. Instead, when detailed error messages are turned on, Windows Azure Websites will save an HTML file into your log files folder when a server error occurs. And that HTML file will contain the details of the error. So let's browse to the site again in order to reproduce that error I just saw. And then I'll show you how I can grab the detailed error message and see what the error actually is. So I'm just going to refresh this, and the error message is back. Now I should have a detailed error message in the log files folder of my site. Now, there are a few ways that I can get to the log files folder, and I'm going to show you a couple of different ones in this video series. This time around, I'm going to use FileZilla to FTP into the site and access the log files folder. All right, so I've launched FileZilla. Now I need to enter a host name for my site in order to FTP into it, and I can find that in the Azure portal. So let's switch back over to the portal real quick. And I'll switch to the dashboard page for this site. And if I scroll down a little bit in this quick glance section over here on the right hand side, I'll scroll down to the FTP hostname. Now if I click this, it'll open the FTP hostname in whatever application is associated with FTP. I don't want to do that. I actually just want to copy this. So I'm going to copy this hostname right here, and then I'm going to flip back over to FileZilla. I'll just Control V right here, stick that in there. Now I also need to get my FTP username so that I can log in, and I can get that from the Azure portal as well. Let's switch over to the portal here real quick. You'll notice here under the deployment FTP user, I have a username listed here. This is because I've already set up my deployment credentials for my Microsoft ID, or what we used to call a live ID. If you haven't done that yet, you'll want to click this link right here that says reset your deployment credentials. And then you'll be able to use those to FTP into any of the websites under your subscription. So since I've already done that, I've got a deployment FTP user here. I'm going to copy this and then back over to FileZilla. I'm just going to Control V to paste that in here. And then I'll enter my password. Port number I can leave blank. And I'll go ahead and click on Quick Connect. And this is going to connect me to my site, and now I'm logged in. Now I'm going to go into the log files folder. And in here you'll see that there is a detailed errors folder. So let's go into that. And I see that there is an HTML file in here. So let's go ahead and open that. I'm going to right click on it and just choose View Edit. And we can see here the error that happened. It looks like I have misspelled compilation in my web.config file. So I need to fix that by editing the web.config file. And I can easily do that with WebMatrix. WebMatrix is a really cool tool for working with Windows Azure websites. And you can get WebMatrix right from inside the Azure portal. So let's switch over to the Azure portal again. So I'm going to click the WebMatrix button down here in the bottom toolbar. Now, if I don't already have WebMatrix installed, it will be installed for me automatically. On this computer, I've already got WebMatrix installed. So my site is now opening in WebMatrix, and I can choose to either edit the site live or to pull down a local copy to my machine. Now, since I just want to fix a problem with my web.config file, I'm just going to edit this live site directly. Now I'm actually looking at the site as it is in Azure, and I'm going to go ahead and open up my web.config file. And I'll scroll down just a little bit, and here's my error right here. So I'm just going to correct this little spelling mistake here, and I'm going to save that. Now, since I chose to edit the site live, as soon as I save this change, it will be live in Azure. So let's go ahead and save that. And I'll close that, and let's minimize WebMatrix and flip back over here to our site. And now let's try browsing this again. Okay, my site's now coming up fine. Great. Now, in this case, my server error was caused by a bad config file. But even if you have an error in your code, detailed error messages is often the best way to find out what's wrong. For more information on detailed error messages and other things that you can monitor for problems in Windows Azure websites, please visit this page on the Windows Azure website. I hope you enjoyed this video on detailed error messages. Thank you for watching.